Hello, Marauders, KP Shamino here, and I'm here with my new build for 2.1. I wasn't planning to remake my build because on first sight there didn't change a lot with the Awakening build. But today I checked the patch and I started to try some gems, and it was really amazed. I was really amazed because my DPS went from 59 in the previous to 79. That's almost 20k DPS more. The survivability is a lot higher. I just random rolled maps. I alchemied like a level 77 map. I just went in with my eyes closed and it runs so smooth. It was unbelievable. So I'm going to show you guys, as always, first my passive talent tree. So, and I'm just going to run over it. Then I'm going to show you guys my gear and my game setup. So let's get going. The core from the last tree, I changed some stuff, not a lot of stuff, but I made the build a little bit better because I checked that I didn't have like a note somewhere that I could skip if I go another route and stuff like that. But if the guys that played the Awakening build, there is not a lot changing, but there are some key notes that are changing, and you guys will see it right away. So if you go to the Marauder section, we are just doing the same. So just go right away to Warrior's Blood. By the way, it's still the same. High life regeneration. I went a little bit higher with life too. You can see around 6k. And then full DPS. So almost all the DPS notes that I can take are in it. So yeah, you guys know I'm a DPS player and I keep being a DPS player. So Warrior's Blood, then we are going to Heart of the Warrior, then we go to Born to Fight, and then we go to Butchery. In the past I went from here to here, but I skipped those four notes because after some thinking, they are not so good. If I can save here four and I just put two here, I come at the same route. So I skipped those. So I went up, and as always, I went to my favorite note, Amplify. So I'm coming first combat stamina. Then I got blunt instrument. Then I went for sanctity. Then I went for discipline and training. Then I went for retribution. And then I'm on Amplify because I think Amplify is still a really good note. And on the way, those notes, they are just, yeah, way too good to not take. Then increased maximum life, 30 to maximum life, so increased armor. Yeah, it's really good, really good. So just go up, take Amplify. Then here you go to the left, of course, Resolute Techniques, and I take those two notes too, Bone Breaker and Skull Cracking, because they boost the DPS yeah, with a lot. Then I go to here to Barbarism, really good note too. And then here I go to the north, I take Devotion, I take here a Jewel Socket. Yeah, it's on the way, and I had still some notes or skills ready to put in, so I took them. And then I went up here. I went to the section where they give reduced mana. You guys will see why I did it. Because I changed a little bit on the gems for my main ability. I'm not using any more blood magic on my ground slam, but you guys will see if we go to the gems. So just go up here and take this note, and that's, yeah, it's not a lot that changed, but that was a key element that you need. Otherwise you cannot run the auras that I'm going to show you guys later on. Okay, that was the north of the tree. So then I'm going to the south. So like this, all the way. I go here a little bit to the north. I take this jewel. I take Berserking, of course. A lot of speed, attack power, good DPS. And I go to Constitution. Once again, way too good to just leave it there. 20 to maximum life, 14 increased maximum life, so really good. Then I go here to the south. In the past I went like this. I took those notes and then I went through here like this. But now I'm going to here. So I'm just going to here, Master of the Arena. I took Bravery and this one I need to take on this build too. Mana flows. You guys will check why. Because in the past I didn't do it, but I need now mana. In the past it was just blood magic, fuck you all and just hit everything you want. But now I need to have mana. Then I go to Art of the Gladiator. And here I go to Destroyer. And that section is done. So I'm not going to here like I already said. No, I'm just coming now from the south to here. So then we are going to here. Go to Bloody Bludgeon. Then you go to the right. Yeah, take those. Wrecking Ball, Executioner. Because yeah, they buff once again the DPS with a tremendous amount of DPS. So that's really good. Then we're going here. Yeah, Golem's Blood. 1.6 life regeneration per second. Really good for this build. And yeah, it was really close, so I took a jewel too. So I got two jewels in this build. This jewel and this jewel. Here I just went to Bloodless. Because for the enemy cannot leech life from you. It's very handy if they cannot do it. And here Unwavering Stance. Just to not be stunned. If a melee gets stunned, most of the time you're dead. And I'm playing a build that you need to watch it a little bit. I forgot one more thingy. In the past I didn't took these passive skills. But now I took them just for the increased maximum life and the reduced mana cost of skills. You guys will see later on why I did it. So that is the build. You guys of course can check it on the website of Bo. I'm going to give the build. I'm going to give some maps. I'm going to give the links like always. Just check it out. And you guys can see how you need to do it. If you want to level, try to go as fast as buffling, as fast as possible to Resolute Techniques. So just do this area. Go to here. And then you can go to Amplify. And then you can choose. You can go here to the left. It depends. If you want your auras really quick, it's best you go here to the left. If you want a little bit more DPS, you go to this section. If you want to go have a little bit more life, you go to this section. So you guys can choose. I got on the road. I got, as you guys can see, here I got 30 int, 30 dexterity. Here I got 30 int, 30 dexterity. If you guys are lacking dexterity or intelligence, just take a note of those until you got a little bit more dexterity, intelligence, plus attributes on your gear. That's why I do it. I don't took it because I got enough on my gear. But if you guys miss some dexterity, intelligence, because I'm running concentrate effects again and faster attacks. And that's 20, level 20, that's 111, and I think 111, 2 times 111 dexterity intelligence. So it's a lot of those things that you are going to need. But you guys can choose what you do. There is a lot of opinions still open for this build. Okay, the gems. Let's have a look. So the gems changed. Yeah, a little bit with the past. There are some still the same, but there is another structure. Because I don't need to protect myself as much as possible than in the past. It's a little bit easier. My build is a little bit easier, and that's really good. So, the first of all, the major thing that changed, I'm not using any more blood magic on Ground Slam. I can keep it up with mana. You guys see that I don't have mana at all, only 51, but I can keep it up. And you guys will see later when I'm doing this map, it's a map tier 10, so a very high map. You guys will see it that I can do it. And I checked it on a single target, it works too. Okay, so just the same like in the past, multi-strike, ground slam, weapon elemental damage, concentrated effects, faster attacks. En melee physical damage, all 2020. Just the same, it's not that difficult. Get your maul, get a lot of increased physical damage on it, get the add physical damage on it, the attack speed, and if you are really rich, you can get a hybrid. Not complicated. I never make complicated guides because otherwise I don't understand my own guides. Therefore, I make them all the time very easy. So, mace, not complicated. Get as high as possible DPS. That's the main issue. And for the other fact, yeah, just check the prices a little bit. You can do a good bargain if you check really good the prices on Po. So then I go for my helm. And my helm, I don't think that I changed anything there. So it's just the same Blood Rage still. For the guys that got a little bit trouble when Blood Rage pop. Because it's going to every time it your life is going down, you guys can just put Iron Will on it. If you think, oh fuck, I'm getting a lot of damage and it just procced and now I'm going to die, just get it out of the build and get Iron Will in it. It will work a lot better. If you guys can maintain your HP. It depends a lot on gear too, so just put it in. It's like a major DPS booster. But yeah, of course, don't go higher than your dexterity allows. I got a level 11 because that's all what my dexterity allows. If you go higher, yeah, the dexterity is going a lot higher. Still, cast when damage taken 2020, molten shell 2020, and still life leech. So if the molten shell explode, the damage that molten shell does. Heals life leech to me. So it's a little bit I call it a little bit the last stand healing, the last chance before dying. So you guys know it from the previous movie. If you like it, just use it. Okay, then for my chest I got a 5 link, but the main problem is that you cannot put Cast when damage taken, Enduring Cry doesn't work anymore. So I did something that I get my endurance charges on. So a lot of people play this. I play it now too because it's indeed really good. So you just do Leap Slam. You link on Leap Slam endurance charges on melee stun. That means if you jump in a group, you are going to stun them with Leap Slam and you are going to get an endurance charge. Simple, not complicated, and it's you are going to survive that moment that you get some damage in. It's really handy. Faster attacks 2020, fortify. I got only two. It's a nice buff. So you jump in the pack, you stun it, you get your endurance charge, and you got fortify. So that's on that moment you're very strong and you can handle a lot. And blood magic. I keep here blood magic because I don't want to waste on the leap. A lot of mana, and I cannot do it because I don't have enough mana. If you go to a single boss, you can just replace Leap Slam with a Heavy Strike at 2020, and you will be okay. That's not a problem. Okay, so that was the setup for the chest. Now I'm going to my gloves, and in my gloves, you guys will see it right away. I got Blasphemy in it. At the start, I was a little bit worried. I was thinking, what the fuck? It just, yeah, a curse becomes an aura. So that means that if enemies comes around you in your aura range, you are going to do automatically the curse on those creatures. I was thinking, yeah, but I just did it with cast when damage low one. But then I started playing and I understand it. It's really good. It's amazing good. I was like, what the fuck? I just run to a pack. Pew! The whole pack was cursed. I didn't need to take damage. That is very important for a melee build. Because if you need to take damage before you can apply a curse, then it's most of the time, for 50% too late. But now you can just apply it and you start attacking. So you can get a little bit more time before you get really hit, and if you play it good, most of the time the ads are dead. So I got Blasphemy. I got it linked with Warlord's Mark. This is a really key element because this maintains my mana for my Grand Slam. So you just go to a pack, you just put Warlord's Mark on that pack, and you can maintain your mana. Even with my 51 mana, I can keep it up. Because it works. You guys will see a little bit later. Okay, sometimes I go out of mana because I'm just doing this sometimes. You see, I'm out of mana now because, yeah, I'm not hitting stuff. But you guys will see, it took some time. But if you are in a pack, you jump in it, you start hitting, you're never going to run out of mana. The 2% mana leech on Warlord's Mark is more than enough. You guys will see it for yourself. Then I got Immortal Call, still low level with Cast When Damage. Yeah, don't look at the four links. Those two are not linked with Cast On Damage. I just got the four link on. But the Cast When Damage taken only procs Immortal Call. Because Immortal Call is, in my opinion, way too good. So what happens? You jump in a group, you get hit, Cast When Damage jumped on Immortal Call. Jumps, so you reduce all the melee damage for 0.40 seconds. On that moment, your Warlord's Mark is up too. You start getting all those endurance charges back up. And with this build at the moment, you got the whole time 4 charges up. It's simple like that. That's my maximum. So 4 charges, I got the whole time up. It's like unbelievable survivability that I got now compared with the past. Okay, so and then for my shoes or my boots, I got Hatred, I got Enlightened. This is really important. I didn't want to do it, but you need Enlightened level 2. Because if you don't got Enlightened level 2, you are going to. You need to put off one of the auras. But you guys will see it's still a major DPS boost compared to the Awakening build. I will show it right away. So Enlightened. Then I got Summon Flame Golem. Yeah, I was thinking the golems are really cute. They give a little bit more DPS. And yeah, you just cast them and they are there. Look, here he is. He does a little bit DPS. He gives a little bit more DPS to me too. So why not? I had still one slot open, so I took the Flame Golem. You guys can choose. You can take another Golem too. The one that you think is the best, just take it. And then I got Herald of the Ash. So that means that I'm running with two real auras and with one curse aura. That's a lot of reserved mana. So I got, I think, in total 42. En 21, dat is 63. En 31, dat is 63, dat is 94. So 94% of my mana is reserved. So I don't got a lot mana left to keep pumping Grand Slam. So I was a little bit worried that I didn't could make it. Because I thought, yeah, my mana is going to be done right away. But it worked. And it's a major DPS boost. Because if you don't need to use blood magic, you can just put. I put multi-strike in it. And that's a lot of DPS that you got more. So that's always good. I got now finally a 6 link with all the DPS that I want with Grand Slam. And that's the first time after I think 3 or 4 builds that I made. So. That's really good. Okay, so for the guys, I already said my Grand Slam is now 79 DPS. If you don't have an Enlightenment gem, look, I will do them away. There is one problem, you don't have enough mana. I got now 34. It's maybe possible that I can do it, but if you cannot keep your Grand Slam up, just put Herald of Ash off. Just get stop the aura. And don't take it. And you guys will still see that I got like 10k more DPS. So it's always, even without Herald of Ash, you still got like a major DPS. Yeah, it's 20% more DPS with my previous build. Okay, for the gear is just the same. Not complicated. Get HP, get armor. Get your resistance capped. Get attack speed. I like attack speed. Attack speed is cool to play. And that's it. And if you are really rich, you can get add physical damage too, like here on this one. And that's all. Armor, HP, resistance, attack speed, DPS. Okay, you guys can check my gear. Okay, for the flasks. The flasks didn't change, so I got an HP flask that get rid of bleeding. Bleeding is really nasty, because the problem with the melee is if you got a bleed, you cannot do a lot about it. So you need a flask for it. You can't just stand there and look to yourself dying. But that's not fun, you know. Then you got the immunity to curses. I got immunity to freeze and chill during flask effect. Then I got Atzeri's promise. Just because my chaos resistance isn't capped. And I think a lot of people it isn't capped. So if I got a lot of animals around me and they're hitting like a truck on me, I pop most of the time this. And of course, my Quicksilver flask, so that I can run really fast the maps. So that was it, guys. A cool build. I like it a lot because it's a lot of DPS. If Blood Rage pups, I go to almost 100k DPS. So that's really good for a non-crit build, I think. So I'm very happy that they changed, yeah, a lot and good stuff too. It's really melee friendly what they did, and that's what I like. So, I think I said everything. You guys know the flask, you know the gear, you know the my gem selection. Everything is of course on the website. I think you guys know the passive tree too. I think I said everything. Okay, maybe the armor you guys want to check. Yeah, like always. I got 9400. If you got 50% estimated physical damage reduction, that's enough. My life regeneration is 475. My mana regeneration is 23.7. Ah, why did I took that the ma reduced mana for the skills is for this? My mana cost of my Ground Slam is only 29. So therefore, I took it in the build too. Okay, of course, cap your resistance. Mine isn't capped at the moment, so that's not so good for me, but I still need to work a little bit on it. That's all what I can say, guys. Okay, for the guys that don't know how the auras work, so you see here my Warlord's Mark. It's just on the box here at the bottom. So what you need to do is, you will see if you pop it up. You push 5, you will see you get like something around you. I think it's pentagram because blasphemy is like witchcrafting, so it's pentagram around it. And you will see if I enter the map, you will see how it works. So I got my golem on too, and now it's a time to get some action in that you guys can see the build. So I got this map prepared so. Enemies, monsters from beyond. I got two rogues. It's not a really complicated map, but it will do. So let's have a look how we can fly with this build. Okay, so first I'm going to show you guys how this new system works with the curse and the auras. Look, do you see above the doggy's head? He got right away the curse on him. So I don't need to do anything. I just need to run to him, and it's okay. That's really handy. And do you see I can just maintain the whole time my mana? So that's really good. Oh, the guys from beyond. Yeah, it's unbelievable. This build, I'm so happy. And now we can jump the 45. And you will see at the top here, Endurance charges on 4. So it's almost whole time maximum. So it's really good, really good. So let's get some pace in it, and now I'm going to show you guys what this build can do. Look, single target, no problem with mana. Let's go a little bit down. Oh, we got the exile here. Ah, it's my brother, the Grand Slam dude. Look, there he goes, my brother. And a single target again. Ah, the dudes from beyond are back. Okay. Yeah, and you guys will see it's really good, the build. So I just killed like an exile. I just killed on the same moment the dudes from beyond. And I killed one of the necromancer, a yellow one, at the same time. And you guys saw that my HP was doing not a lot. So I think the build is really good. You didn't saw me going out of mana, so that's really good too. So enjoy the build, guys. That's all what I can say. I hope that you guys enjoy the build. If you like my movie, please give a like. If you like my channel, subscribe please. And otherwise, Marauders, keep ground slamming, and see you guys with the next patch. Bye bye.